Tiny, you are frozen.
Yep, there it is, the first fruit in the most recent generation of my oldest chili breeding line. Let me remove those dried up petals. That's better, nice. As you can see, the fruit is standing upright and is white in color with a hint of purple, so far. Now there were quite a bit of flowers dropped, but there are many new fruits developing right now if we look a bit in the vicinity. Ah, right there. A fruit in an early stage of development, as you can see right there. And there are more, like here for example, or maybe here, and I expect many more to come, because it's still flowering quite profoundly. So what's the deal with Old Spice here, and why am I so happy that it's fruiting? Well, like I said, it is the most recent generation of my oldest chili breeding line, and there's a considerable sentimental value attached to that, and furthermore, it took a really, really, really long time for it to finally produce fruits. And, well, let me just start with the beginning. That's a good idea. So, this is how I denote its ancestry using my little notation style. An X means a cross, and the female of the cross is always on the right side. Yeah, now let me just go through it, starting with the beginning. This was my very first chili pepper. It was a simple cayenne that I crossed in 2006 with a hot paper lantern, which is a variety of habanero suitable for more colder climates. Here are some snapshots I recovered from these early days of chili breeding. They depict the F2 generation of this cross, if I'm correct. And it was a little bit pathetic maybe, but it went on and into my Old Spice cross. And on it went for three generations to be precise. After that I crossed in the Sibirische Hauspaprika, it was called in German, so I guess it would be Siberian house pepper, I guess. And it is a variety of chili that is supposedly grown in Siberia on the windowsills, and it is said to be well adapted to short growing seasons. Again, I followed this cross for three generations. Funnily enough, the result was a plant with round or at least roundish fruits, although none of the documented ancestors had such fruits. A bit strange, right? Back in university I had a small plant of Numex Twilight, you know, this very nice, attractive, decorative chili pepper, standing at my workstation, and then winter came and I just left it outside in the garden, didn't think much about it, and then the next year in summer I went on the garage to clean up some leaf litter and so on, and I found a plant which I thought, this is a nightshade family member, right? It looks kind of like a chili, but how could a chili get there? And the, I think what happened was that birds fed on the fruits that were still left on the chili, and then they flew on the twig of this apple tree that was above the garage, and well, they pooped, and in the poop there was a seed of this chili pepper. And maybe because of all the rotting biomass on this dirty garage roof, it was able to germinate and to grow. I took it inside, and well, this is the F1 generation of the Numex Twilight, so to speak, and it became the big mother of my Old Spice cross. I figured, this is one lucky plant. It managed to disperse just like its wild ancestors back in Sonora Desert in northern Germany. So it had a lot of luck, and maybe a bit of this luck can transfer to me. And so this is basically my good luck chili breeding line. I then pollinated this Numex Twilight with my other chili breeding line, the Caryolochia, namely the F2 generation. And finally, the resulting plant received pollen from the breeding line that goes back to my very first chili, described earlier. And the result was this, and then it gets really weird. It appears that in following generations, this breeding line became less and less fertile. The generation just before the most recent one did not start fruiting until its second year, and it was only just one single fruit, if I remember correctly. From this fruit, I grew two plants. One I took to my office in a continuation of the tradition started with this Numex Twilight plant, and the other one I took home. They germinated in 2017. In 2018, there were flowers on the plant at home, but they were strangely deformed and did not produce a single fruit. The individual in my office started to flower in 2019. The flowers looked nice, but they too produced no fruits. And that's why I'm so happy that there are apparently now many fruits on the way. It will be interesting to see what happens. Not for heat or taste or anything, but just for fun.